I'm Monica Pearson with This Week in Black History. It was on December 9, 1872, that Union Army officer P.B.S. Pinchback became the nation's first African-American governor when he was sworn in as governor of Louisiana. Pinchback was born Pinckney Benton Stewart in 1837 in Macon, Georgia, to a former slave named Eliza Stewart and her former master, Major William Pinchback. Eliza moved the family to the Free State of Ohio after Major Pinchback's death to avoid being claimed as slaves by his family. And in 1862, Pinckney Stewart joined the Union Army to fight in the Civil War. He became one of the Union's few black commissioned officers and led an infantry of mostly refugee slaves. In 1863, Stewart resigned and moved back to the South to enter a life of politics, taking up his father's name of Pinchback. In 1868, he was elected to the State Senate of Louisiana and quickly climbed the ranks of the state government, becoming lieutenant governor in 1871. The next year, an impeachment hearing against Governor Henry Clay Warmoth led to Pinchback taking the oath of office as America's first black governor. Although he only held the office for 6 weeks, Pinchback's political career was far from over. As a Republican, he was elected Louisiana's first black congressman in 1873, though a Democrat contested the election, and Congress eventually awarded the seat to Pinchback's opponent. In his later life, Pinchback served on the committee that challenged the state of Louisiana in the case of Plessy versus Ferguson and raised grandson, Gene Toomer, who would rise to prominence as a poet in the Harlem Renaissance. P.B.S. Pinchback would be the last black governor of any state until Douglas Wilder's election in Virginia in 1989.